It has a mic start. Hello, hello, and welcome back to another new stream. Everything works well, you should be seeing Life is Strange Beyond the Storm. Yes, it uses autosave. Last week on Friday we started into the first episode of Beyond Before the Storm, which is a prequel to the original Life is Strange 1, which we will play afterwards. And yeah, as you can see, things went a little wild. As yeah, Chloe got into contact with Rachel Amber, who is still mysterious and giving me a bit of the wrong vibes here. Well, yeah, that was Rachel burning a photograph and kicking the trash can over, and then a strong wind came and now everything burns. Oh, we went now go into a brave new world. I go in absolutely blind. I hope I make the right decisions. And
previously,
yeah.
On Life is Strange Before the Storm. I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
Hey, dickhead!
Get the fuck out of here!
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me.
Hello, Black Hell.
Chloe, do something!
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here. Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Damn, they are really going at it.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman? That was my dad. And that woman was definitely not my mom.
No, it apparently wasn't. Yeah, it was a wild ride. Not gonna lie.
Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner and then... just... sorry.
Why are we here?
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process.
One of you isn't.
Is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. When that respect is violated...
reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
Don't get in trouble again?
Trouble is merely the byproduct, Miss Price. What's at issue is your attitude. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
Oh, great. And I would also hate it there.
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language. Witnesses saying you were involved in bullying Nathan Prescott.
Oh shit!
Involved means not sticking out my neck for Blackwell's richest ass child. I didn't realize that was a crime.
Your lack of awareness does not absolve you of anything, Miss Price.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
Favoritism.
Mom, you know this is all bullshit, right?
Chloe, now is not the time.
And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
What does that mean?
It means... you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. I have no choice
but
to...
I made her do it.
What?
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 What? Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far. Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me. You're better than this. But I wouldn't listen. See, Chloe was afraid I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me. But only to keep me safe. I'm just sorry you got caught up in it, Chloe.
Interesting
you
development,
yeah. You allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
Yeah, sure.
We're cool. Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe,
is this
true?
Kid.
It's true.
Totally not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Miss Price?
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel.
Ray.
Just to Ray? Be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
Coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like Rachel...
Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Do you have a list of students you assume the worst about? You have no right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it?
Let's all just calm down.
Oh, quickly the attitude changes here.
She's been through in the last 2 years. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Miss Price.
Mrs. Price.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
I understand, Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed in you.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period. And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
No.
What? Are you insane?
Your discipline is still pending, Miss Price.
Ray, she loves that show. Since this is her first infraction,
Mr.
don't you think,
Amber, I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please don't tell me how to run my school.
Oh boy.
There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances, accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy...
Victoria Chase.
Oh, fucking course.
I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
That is such...
What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next. Unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
Ooh. If I fuck this up,
no way is Rachel missing the play for me. But thanks to her acting skills, I'll have to go down in flames if I want to fix this.
Backtrack your list to your opponent, she's a related comeback.
Get your head out of your ass, Wells.
Chloe!
You seriously think yesterday was Little Miss Sunshine's idea?
Miss Amber has accepted her responsibility.
You're punishing her for taking the blame for me? For trying to be a good person? That makes you even more clueless than I thought.
Rachel confessed. Are you calling her a liar?
I confess to thinking she can act like a... motherfucker, you just bought her crap. Hook, line, and sinker.
You don't have to do this. It's okay. Really.
Nope.
Don't tell me what to do. I'm not one of your sycophants. I'm a lone wolf, and you're a little Red Riding Hood. Welcome to grandmother's house, bitch.
Chloe, this can't be you. Apologize this instant.
Fine. I'm sorry for bullying Nathan. But if you had to look at that smug face as often as I do...
I've heard enough. Rachel, you were clearly trying to cover for your classmate. I appreciate the motive, but I appreciate honesty more. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
You will not be removed from the play.
Was that so hard?
Thank you.
And Miss Price, I came into today's meeting planning to suspend you for the rest of the school year.
Oh, did you?
With a chance for reinstatement in the fall.
And now?
You are expelled.
What? No.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives. That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price, Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
I have the feeling I went with a majority decision here to take the fall.
I'm sorry. Nothing to be sorry about. Meet me at the junkyard later? You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
Mom,
I'll see you. In the parking lot.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip?
You know I was supposed to have today off, right?
Sorry that my totally fair and impartial hearing inconvenienced you, man.
Oh boy.
I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here. Dad got Bongo from the rescue shelter. Then he got run over.
Oh, the poor cat.
Moral of the story, no one's ever really rescued. Trusty keeper of my graffiti pens. You've served.
There's some. Poster goes out.
Jackpot. Wait. What the hell?
You had to borrow your staff. Desperate times, you know. I promise I get you back next week. Hmm. Oh.
Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me. Bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
I doubt I will be able to make it fast. To see when we play Life is Strange 1 if all this is still there in some capacity. That stupid look on her face was already worth it.
Later, Skip.
Later.
Looks like David's here.
Talking with a leaf.
Awesome. Max would have loved this shit.
Hello, Elliot.
Hey, Elliot.
What brings Chloe Price to school on a Saturday morning? Nothing good, I bet.
I was expelled.
Wait, really? Holy shit!
I know. I'm surprised it took this long, too.
Do you want a hug?
Let's not make a big deal out of this.
Oh, sorry. Right, yeah. Was Rachel Amber involved?
Yeah.
And let me guess, did she get off scot-free?
Nope.
Well, yeah. But she tried to cover for me.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, what are you doing here?
I should come early to grab tickets. For the Tempest? You said we might see it together.
Oh, right. Good call.
Did you get my text about hanging out afterwards?
Sorry, Elliot, but I'm probably gonna hang out with Rachel. You know, post-show celebration and whatever.
Oh, cool. That makes sense.
I better go. My mom is waiting to stick her attack mustache on me. Her boyfriend. Don't worry about it. See you around, Elliot.
Yeah. Later.
You better break his heart now than later.
It's about damn time.
David, please.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
And?
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
If my mother has something to say, she will say it to me.
She has. The problem is, you don't listen. Maybe
argument.
If you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What?
Like?
Like how to have no job? Or how to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner?
Someone needed my help.
Who? Your friend Rachel? Because I think the daughter of the DA is going to be just fine. I need your help. Me, your mother. We need to get our own house in order. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I care about Joyce very much. I'm willing to forgive you for the incident yesterday.
Incident?
If you improve your attitude going forward.
Incident? What incident?
Chloe was incredibly out of line. She insulted me. Swore at me. But with an apology, I'm willing to start over.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
How fitting that my last joint was taken away.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe, and I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
We feel this is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
Oh, we are going to comply.
Fine. You want to see my shit so badly? You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Angry teenager?
Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
I forgive you. You were under a terrible influence.
I just worry about you, but that's no excuse.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
Oh, boy.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
Anger!
Mom, I know I fucked up. I'm a fuck up. I'm sorry.
Are you sorry? You don't even know what you're apologizing for.
I've been shutting you out even though I've needed you, and you need me, and I know that. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
Oh boy, are you in a surprise for Life is Strange 1? Are you in for a surprise?
Hey!
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
That is an awful lot of hip sways there.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down? Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left? Ugh.
Yeah, that battery is done for.
This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it. This beast will ever run again. The first thing it needs is a new battery. Wonder if I can find one around here. I guess I'll never ride one of these again. That's so awesome. You're a long way from the beach.
One could say that.
Here's a side of Arcadia Bay they don't put on the postcards. What are you trying to hide under their hood?
They're locked. Alright, good battery. Come here with me.
Here we go. The pick of the litter.
Anything else interest?
About opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
is that? Well, I didn't expect him to throw us out there, like, directly. Yeah, I doubt that technically you can repair a car that stands around there like that with just, you know, replacing a battery.
More love than I can give right now. In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit.
I can't stand going home to... Yeah. Having something from home there. You better.
While an escape hatch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole. Probably a good idea to cover over this with something. I bet if I look, I can find something else to fix inside the truck. I bet if I look, I can find something else to fix inside the truck. Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here.
Hey, I already know that there's a tower.
Okay, let's see what else this trash heap has to offer. This could cover that torn seat, and look awesome doing it. Don't tell me what to do. You might not work. Then again, I hardly ever work.
I mean, it's worth a try.
Wow. Shitty ride, drug dealer. Really thought crime paid better. I used to love opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
Welcome, Matt.
You should cover that life-endangering floor hole quite nicely.
Of course, Chloe has infinite storage capacity. Looks like it's new. Works for now.
This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. Probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable. Still, how sweet would that be?
How sweet would it be?
Yeah?
Bryce, it's Frank.
Oh. Hey, Frank. What's up?
Yeah, just checking in to see how you're doing.
Really?
No. Listen, we've got some business to discuss. Where can we meet?
What about? Oh, like drugs?
Bryce.
I'm hanging out in the junkyard, north of town.
The junkyard? That's great. Stay there, I'll see you soon.
Okay. And Frank? After you hang up, are you going to smash your phone, like, in the movies? And if so, can I smash it?
No.
Trust me, Price. If I ever have to smash anything, you'll want nothing to do with it. I'll see you.
All right. We keep away from you then, and your business, and go not snooping around as long as the story doesn't dictate it.
Time for a hard-earned smoke break. You only get one chance to make a first impression. The eye sees all.
That's the eye.
Does your truck look like an aquarium on wheels? Didn't think so.
Does it honk? It honks. Oh, no drugs, but she's allowed to smoke.
I'm trying to reach out, I know I'll get there soon. There's a hole in the earth here, and we're walking.
I asked the burning over there.
We
get a DSM or small part of the stream silence again on Twitch. Already happened on the last one.
Shit. I slept all day. What the hell?
Yeah, the thing flapping its tiny wings. He's dreaming again.
Dad?
Going on in A. Island treatment, huh?
Amazing, isn't it? I can't look away.
Sure.
Don't pretend you're not mesmerized, too. See? You're so drawn to it. You don't even realize the danger.
Danger?
Fire blinds us, just like darkness. But darkness blinds with absence, with loss.
What does fire blind with?
Anger.
Beauty. But sometimes, there's a greater beauty yet to come.
Oh.
Incredible.
Fire is jealous, Chloe. It wants all the beauty for itself. That's why you need to be careful.
Careful of what?
Of getting burned.
Yes!
Hasn't anyone ever told you not to fall asleep with a lit cigarette? You could start a fire. So, are you gonna invite me in? Or what?
I love giving rides to strange drifters. Hop in.
Thanks. You've been busy.
It's nothing. Just some junk I found lying around.
A rainbow towel? A freaky red light?
Yep.
Holy shit. The all-seeing eye.
Figured it can't hurt to have the Illuminati on our side for whenever shit goes down.
Always thinking ahead. Chloe, this is incredible. I can't believe you found us an escape vehicle already.
That's the hope. But it doesn't exactly drive yet.
You'll figure it out. And while you're at it, we're also gonna need some money. You know, to buy stuff.
Uh-huh. Car and money? Anything else you'd like?
Luckily, there's no rush.
True. And no Blackwell.
Holy shit. That Wells meeting. I'm so sorry.
All right.
I can't believe he actually expelled you.
Why not? No reason to prolong the inevitable.
It's definitely Blackwell's loss. You covering for me was amazing. I don't know how to thank you.
Whatever. You tried to cover for me, too.
Tried and failed. I guess we know who the better liar is.
Or maybe my lie was the one he wanted to believe.
At least Wells has no idea what really went down with us last night. Shit got pretty wild.
That it did, yes.
Last I checked, you're the one who went all Puff the Manic Dragon on that tree last night.
What were you thinking? I was angry. I didn't expect the whole stupid park to go whoosh. But come on, doesn't accomplice sound way cooler than accessory after the fact?
Is that the official Arcadia Bay DA's opinion? Accomplice it is. I'd be way happier going to jail than having to live at home with Dictator David. He announced his plans to move in this morning.
Great timing.
Chloe, that's awful. I'm so sorry. You know what we both could use? Therapy.
Therapy.
You start. Kick back and tell me what's bothering you.
Well, Doc. I've been booted from school, and I'm not entirely sure what to do about it.
You mean how to cope with your feelings of anger and disappointment?
No. I mean how to express my feelings of intense joy.
Uh-huh. Do you think you might be taking this a little too well?
You tell me. I'd say I'm exceptionally well-adjusted.
I'd bet my therapist's license that no one's ever called you that before.
Touché, Doc.
You might be right, Sarah.
So, my new friend, who everyone thinks is perfect, did something batshit fucking nutso last night. What do I do?
This perfect friend of yours, who I'm assuming is also an exceptional beauty, sounds like she may have been inspired by someone new in her life. Someone who is also, may I add, a knockout in the looks department. Perhaps this friend of yours, who, I reiterate, must be just stunning, needed someone in her life to teach her.
How to
stay. I call bullshit on that!
How not to give a fuck. Because she was tired of having to give so many fucks all the time.
That makes sense.
I do not buy her story, not at all.
There's this dildo with a mustache who's been dating my mom, and now he thinks he's moving in with us. How do I stop him?
That's a hard one. I'm not sure there's really anything you can do.
Then what the hell am I talking to you for?
Just because you can't stop him doesn't mean you don't fight back. The resistance begins now. All right. You're going to need a new nickname to mark your enemy. What have you got?
He's a step douche, because he's inserting himself where he doesn't belong. Also, he's a douche.
Poetic. May I also suggest stepladder?
Why stepladder?
Because he climbs on your mom every night. Ew!
Ooh!
They'll be stepping down the aisle.
What the hell kind of therapist are you?
Sorry. It's called shock therapy. Highly controversial.
That was actually somewhat therapeutic.
Considering that technically shock therapy is done with literally electroshocks to the brain.
Chloe Price.
And now it's your turn. Tell me all about what it's like being daughter of Arcadia Bay's most famous scumbag.
It sucks.
Too blunt? Sorry. I do that sometimes.
Nah, I'm just
Ugh, I don't know. Can we talk about something else? Of course. I kind of fixed the truck a bit. That might mean I have life skills, something I've really tried to avoid. Upshot, I'm closer to becoming a car thief.
That's pretty badass.
Yeah. Takes some work for.
Do you think there's a point when you've been acting so much that you don't even have your own personality anymore? You're just whatever you think other people want you to be.
I think you have a personality.
I wasn't talking about me. My dad doesn't really exist. You saw him in Wells' office. The whole thing is a performance. And now I'm starting to feel like everything in my life is bullshit. But he's still my dad. How can I make sure I don't end up like him?
You couldn't be like him even if you wanted to. You're too awesome.
The fact that you believe that makes me feel better.
Why, Foe? We met like 2 days ago. Phew!
Shit. It's time for the play. As if my life didn't have enough drama in it.
Good luck.
You know you're never supposed to tell an actor good luck before a show? It's bad luck.
How is telling someone good luck bad luck?
You're supposed to say, break a leg.
That's dumb.
Hey, I was thinking that after the show, maybe we could go do something. Just you and me.
Something criminal?
Criminally fun.
I'm in. Wait, you forgot your bag.
It's for you. Just a little survival kit for your new life on the lam. Drive safe, Chloe.
The hell?
Hello, Junk Shack.
Yeah, until it rains.
Time to check out Rachel Amber's mystery bag. A bag full of clothes.
Well, that's better than nothing.
Yes, I need those. Nothing like an abandoned shack in the middle of a junkyard to make a girl feel like exploring a new wardrobe.
Not quite. Ah, classic Chloe. Hey, what a party. I forgot there was bonus stuff with it. Not quite. That's a bit much. Yep, I go with that. Oh, the RV. What are you doing here?
Yo, Frank! It's Chloe. I don't know the secret password, man. Is the password drugs?
Price, get your ass in here.
Okay.
Dude, it smells like piss in here.
Shut up.
You have a rough night or something?
Every night's a rough night. I've got a notebook in the back somewhere. Go get it for me, would you?
Who is that one? Ah! Cat, jeez, man.
Get my notebook, Price. Then we'll talk.
Now I'm fetching things for Frank.
Bad news? Who's Justin?
How low can I go?
And we're back. You're listening to 87.9 FM, the Sator. I have with me Jack Kearney, Chief of the Arcadia Bay Fire Department.
Got it.
I'm gonna cut right to the chase, Jack.
All right.
How about civilians and all this? Are we gonna have to prepare to come to that? Well, the fire is spreading in an unusual way, sort of surrounding the northern.
Hey there. Okay, little guy.
Aw, shit! Pompidou! Get up here!
Aww.
Pompidou?
You little killer.
Don't oversell yourself, Elliot.
Is this what I think it is? Ugh, shit. I'm in the red. Time to find out what Frank wants to discuss. Is this it?
Have a seat.
Yeah, how to get $175.
Badass name for a dog.
It's French.
Does it mean, like, tough guy or something?
Do I look like I speak fucking French?
Okay, so who was that woman?
What woman?
The one I saw coming out of your RV.
Oh yeah, I meant to introduce you. Her name is Mind Your Own Fucking Business.
Nice name.
Rachel would want to know more. I bet I can convince Frank it's harmless to tell me.
Dude, I'm just curious. What's the big deal?
Idiot. I make money by being discreet.
Frank, you know I hate everyone. Who do you think I'm gonna tell?
Come on, Price, I gotta protect my clients. Happy customers are the foundation of a good business.
Your customers like you because you're laid back. That's why I like you. So you should keep building up that easygoing vibe, you know?
Sure, I guess. So why are you so hung up on this chick?
Come on, Frank. This is Arcadia Bay. Gossip is all we have to keep us from hanging ourselves out of boredom.
I don't know.
Frank. Talk. And I'll get my mom to make you something special.
Like what? How about that firehouse chili of hers?
Cool.
You got it.
The woman you saw. Her name's Sarah. Showed up a few weeks ago, causing all kinds of trouble for all sorts of people.
Like who?
It's a little out of your league, okay?
But what kind of trouble, exactly?
Forget about it, Chloe. Shouldn't have opened my mouth.
Okay.
Thanks for telling me.
Did a fire starter.
You hear the mill burn down?
Shit. Really?
Crazy. My friend Damon runs the place. He lost a lot of money last night.
Uh-oh.
How about you? Did you lose anything in the fire?
No. But I'll probably get pulled into whatever shit Damon's dealing with right now. Lately, he's been doing some stuff that I don't like. But I don't seem to have much leverage with him like I once had. Anyway, you and I have shit to discuss.
Is this about the $175?
What?
The money that I owe you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I don't give a shit about that.
Oh?
Wait, do you have it?
Give me like another week. I don't have enough right now.
I wonder if I'll ever get tired of your crap. You're lucky you're the least of my problems. Open my notebook. Last page.
Alright, what do we have then?
Drew. You know him?
Drew North? Yeah, he's... Holy shit. That's a lot of money.
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Apparently football players eat it like candy.
That's smart, I guess.
Oh shit.
Pays well?
Go Bigfoots. Problem is, Drew owes a grant, and he's not answering my calls. You know what's going on with him?
He's an unreliable douchebag.
Nah, this is the first time he's done this. Kid's actually smart.
Is he?
Anyway, here's the job. I'm taking you to Blackwell. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up. Can you handle that?
Yeah, of course, but what's in it for me?
Idiot, you still owe me.
So, if I do this, then we're good?
That, and I'll do even better. I'll give you a 10% cut of the money.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll do it.
What's the matter?
It might be a little tough. I'm not supposed to be at Blackwell. I got expelled this morning.
Congratulations. Still easier for you to go on campus than for me. If you can't even do this, Price.
$100 closer to leaving Arcadia Bay. With a bit of cash and the truck fixed, Rachel and I could really do it.
You could.
We could leave for good. I'll do it.
Good deal.
Oh Oh boy. This is spreading drama. Also, at the next hospital time when we have control. Again, I will be making more cut. Once we reach the 1 hour mark already.
Didn't think I'd be back this soon. Well, here goes nothing.
Back at school yet again, of course. Got figments.
You better hurry up and get into the dorms.
Yes, we will do that. I may or may not attempt things on sales coming. We will see about that, how well I do. Regardless, this will be it for the first part of the stream. I hope you had some fun so far, and that I will see you all around for the next part. This was Nox Destin host, all of you. Evening, good night, good day, depending on when and where you're watching this. Until the next time, stay safe, stay healthy, see ya, and bye.